Thank you. company is a chicken company.
What chicken?
We are called One Point.
One Point.
Yeah, we bought this property and we made it this year.
Ah.
And we have a chicken that's here and there.
Thank you. fun game, doesn't it? Yeah?
Did you over there?
Saturday, I came into the finest McDonald's and Ravens in the back sink, and he had a mopper up in the sink, and he brought an old toothbrush from home. And he was literally scrubbing the corners and crevices in this mopper.
Des Plaines store had to be perfect because it was the showcase he would use to sell McDonald's franchises to the rest of the company. For each franchise he sold, he would collect 1.9% of the operator's gross sales. From that, he would give Dick and Mac half of 1%. Croc sold 18 franchises his first year in business, but he was shocked to learn that he was barely earning enough to cover his expenses.
He was so anxious to get into the business of McDonald's. He basically gave him a deal that they could refuse. Unfortunately, he gave him a deal on which he could not make money. So he had Eric Seinborn to show him how to make money, not selling hamburgers, but real estate.
Seinborn was the financial genius behind the McDonald's. Under this plan, Trump set up a separate corporation that would purchase or lease the land on which all McDonald's restaurants would be located. Franchisees would then have to pay him a set monthly rental or a percentage of their sales, whichever was greater.
That put Ray's interest in absolute parallel with his own franchisee's interest. Franchisee was motivated to sell more, and Ray only made his money when the franchisee sold more. So the concept of renting real estate to franchisees was absolutely critical to the success of McDonald's in every respect.
With his real estate formula in place, Croc set out to meet his goal of opening 1,000 McDonald's from coast to coast. His search for new locations was endless. Ray was in his mid-50s and...